If we look at the construction of our galaxy, we will see that we have an estimated 100 billion stars therein, in our Milky Way galaxy. And if we look at the construction of the human brain, we will see that it also has 100 billion cells. Now, according to the Nath Sadhana, the Nath Sampradaya, when the individual consciousness in the yogi evolves to a state where every neuron in his brain cells connects with the stars, that is, the 100 billion neurons have a connection with 100 billion stars, then cosmic consciousness is said to have been expressed and the yogi attains to the final nirvana. If you also look carefully and we study the cosmos, we study our galaxy, we see in the center of the galaxy a Brahma Gufa, a cave of Brahma, a supermassive black hole which swallows up the night, swallows up time, swallows up matter and causation. The law of physics break down and go into the great deep of nothingness called the Mahankal, he who is the great time and the great zero, not zero. Similarly, in the human brain, in the center of the human brain, there is also a miniature cave of Brahma. This cave of Brahma is the third ventricle. When, according to the Nath tradition, the yogi does his meditation up the spinal cord and merges into the third ventricle, into the cave of Brahma, which is situated, he loses all self-sense and in a flash connects with the cosmic black hole in our galaxy and realizes himself as the universe.
Free of delusion, the yogi knows that birth and death of the body are mere chapters in his life story, and that he is the eternal river of consciousness flows on.
Ekam nityam vimalam achalam sarvadhi sakshibhutam bhavatitam trigunarahitam satgurum tvam namamim.
In the human brain lies the corpus callosum. Connected to the corpus callosum is the Hamsa swan. There are ventricles in the human brain in the shape of the Hamsa, the swan in flight, with its wing-like lateral ventricles thrust towards the forehead and its head pointing towards the back of the skull, as though flying back to the future faster than light.
Gagan mandalu me hamsa dole oham soham pankh pasare.
Since eons, yogis have reported seeing a hamsa during meditation. What is this hamsa? What is its connection with us? This swan of light is not merely the fantasy of a yogi or the imagination of an artist. This photograph, scanned from a medical text, is the actual coronal cross-section of our brain. Within each of us lies this divine legacy, the luminous Hamsa that Indian yogis realized as the seat of their soul.
As the Hamsanath yogi meditates and progresses by spiritual pranayam along the path, he activates the kundalini energy up the spinal cord and brings it to the third eye center, the Shivanetra. Now in the third eye center, there is the Agya Chakra. The two petals of the Agya Chakra form the eye of Shiva as they carve around one another and join on top of the head. The Hamsanath Yogi sees the Shivanetra, which is just in front of the cave of Brahma.
त्रियेनन अब भेद उड़े हैं तोड़ के जन्म मरण के ताले ब्रह्मानंद सहोदर सुनकर अनहद अनहद वाणी बोले गगन मंडल में हंसा डोले।
Within the center of the eye is the scintillating white star called the Kuthastha Chaitanya. This is the Bindu representing Shiva, the Supreme Lord of creation, preservation and destruction. When the yogi, by constant years of meditation, penetrates the star, he is already in a state of Sabikalp Samadhi. He penetrates the star and enters into a state of Nirvikalpa Samadhi. And now this lofty soul, radiant in his splendor, rests with his pranic spiritual energy in the ventricles of the Hamsa swan, which are the lateral ventricles in the brain. And there he gets his vastest and greatest of spiritual realization beyond the reckoning of humankind. And he evolves by spiritual progress. The evolution of human consciousness is still going on. As the human brain develops vaster and more beautiful, the texture refines. The 100 billion cells in the human brain are uniting with the 100 billion stars in our galactic system. And they go beyond the galactic system into the wonderful state of supernal splendor of Niranjan Nirvan, Kaivalya Samadhi, the Nirvan. His physical brain and body cannot take it much, but the ultimate stage is that the corona radiata in his brain cells, these subtle fibers, these tubes, light up with a divine effulgence. This radiant splendor goes and spreads in its aura far beyond the earth system, way into the galaxies.
Name dvesha rago name lobha moho mado naiva me naiva matsal.
The cosmic web is transient, constantly forming and reforming, shaping itself anew. So the truth seeker goes beyond matter and light in his quest for the still and thoughtless mind, the Unmani.
Aham bhojanam naiva bhojam na bhokta chidananda rupa shivoham shivoham na mrutyur na shanka na me jati bheda pita naiva me naiva mata cha janma na bandhur na mitra gurur naiva shishya chidananda rupa shivoham.
Unmani, the state of limitless soul awareness, is samadhi.
हम परदेसी बा देश भए जहां हर दिन होरी होत वहां सप्त रंग पिच कार फुआर हम निर्गुण रंगी होत तरे भाई निर्गुण अंगी होत.
The Unmani avastha, the still mind state, the no mind state of natural enlightenment is in the true essence of yoga sadhana. Over here, nirguna rangi hot, the yogi, when is drunk with the state of his own divinity, he finds the seven colors of rag and dvesh, attraction and repulsion, lust and greed, melt away, the seven colors of the spectrum. When he spins and whirls internally in his consciousness, the seven colors of attachment dissolve into the color white, the immaculate white, and he is free from the trammels of the senses and material desires. After he has done with material desires and detachment from the senses, he is virakt, and he goes into a certain sound, the birthing hum of creation, and everything to him is the sound of the omkar, the creative hum of the cosmic motor. Beyond the Unmani avastha, where he goes and he forms the third eye within the depths of his own consciousness in the cave of Brahma, the golden rim, the blue center, and the scintillating white star. The yogi in Unmani avastha is in a state of bhav samadhi, sabikalp samadhi, but when he penetrates the star, he goes into a state of nirvikalp samadhi.
वहां ध्यानन स्थानन नादन बिंद आकाश नहीं वहां काल कहां सब शून्य अशून्य का हैपन है ईश्वर भी निरंकार वहां
विभुत्वाच सर्वत्र सर्वेन्द्रियाणां समावेशमत्व न मुक्तिर्न बन्ध चिदानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं